Rex Orange County is back. So Rex Orange County is back with his new album, Who Cares? This is 3 years in the running after his previous album, Pony, came out. I think it was 3 years ago. But yeah, I'm excited to hear this album, and I actually just got tickets to see him later this month, so I need to study this album as best as I can. Let's see. Here, Who Cares? So, full disclosure, there are a couple of songs here that I've already listened to, and by a couple I mean two. And those two are the ones that were already released, so I'm not cheating. Those are Keep It Up and Amazing. But yeah, I think I'm going to upload this as like a one take type of thing. I'm not sure yet, but I guess we'll see. So yeah, feel free to follow along or skip to whichever song you want to see the reaction of. I have my Tony's Chocolonely here, not sponsored, but they're a good brand, very ethical. And yes, let's dig in. First up, we want to Keep It Up. Now, I've already heard this song, by the way, so just so you know, this is not a first reaction. Actually, you can watch the reaction of that video up there, wherever.
Keep it up and go on. You're only holding out for what you want. Oh, the strangers, it's enough, it's enough. Keep it up and go on. Only holding out for what you want. So frustrated, it's enough. Keep it up. People I've never met,
and I don't know if this is correct.
I guess it's stress. Self-respect. Most of my life I've found someone.
But anytime I give it a try, hey.
Keep it up and go on. You're only holding out for what you want. Oh, the strangers, it's enough. It's enough, keep it up and go on. Yeah, you're only holding out for what you want. It's enough, keep it up.
Yeah, it's enough.
I really had enough.
I'm not the biggest fan of this bridge, if I'm being honest. It feels a little empty. But I love the chorus.
You're only holding out for what you want. You know that all the strangers, it's enough, it's enough. Keep it up and go on. Yeah, you're only holding out for what you want. It's enough, keep it up.
That was Keep It Up. Keep It Up. I've already reacted to this. You can watch the reaction there. If that pops up. it's a nice song, a nice tune. I don't think his best tune, but very catchy. One of his more catchy songs. The bridge was not that. It didn't hook me enough. It felt like an afterthought in a way, but the overall song was nice. But yeah, overall I would rate that I don't know if I should rate these songs yet. Okay, at the end of this whole video, I'm going to do a save or no save, where I go down the list of the songs on this album and see whether they're worth keeping or not. Okay, nice. So, next song we have... Ooh, I don't want this to be on shuffle. Next song we have Open a Window featuring Tyler, the Creator. Now, I know this song was released a day ago at this point, but knowing that the album was coming out, you know, tonight, I decided not to hear it early so that I can have more songs to listen to during this release. So yes, Open a Window featuring Tyler, the Creator. There's a lot of strings I noticed throughout the album. The bass in the background is a voice. This is smooth. Is this R&B? Okay, pause. Open a Window. That was pretty good, I must say. That, I don't know what genre exactly that was, but it reminded me a lot of late 90s. Was it late 90s? Might have been late 80s, early 90s. a lot of 90s. I know that genre was popular somewhere in the 90s. Yeah, it reminds me of old school songs that had that kind of vibe with rap on top, which is, you know, perfect for this vibe. That was nice. And to be fair, I'm not like the biggest Tyler the Creator listener. Don't at me. But that was a nice feature. And is that the only feature on this album? Yeah, that was the only feature on this album. So that was well worth it. Very nice song. Next up, we have Worth It. Second new song that I have yet to hear. So this will be interesting. I seem to be noticing the strings theme throughout this album. It's very movie-like. Very Disney-like, in fact. We're like a third into the song, or a quarter into the song, and the singing has yet to start. Oh, there we go. Ooh. I love this beat. Background. I love this. It. That song was worth it. I really like the beat of that song in particular. I'm a sucker for good beats, basically. And the beat itself also sounded very 90s. There's a genre to it. It's not New Jack Swing, but it's like somewhere there. But yes, Worth It was a good song. And so far, if I'm gonna be honest, Keep It Up was the lead single that was released. I feel like either of those two songs so far, and the upcoming song Amazing, which I've also already heard, could have been better for singles than Keep It Up. No hate on that song, it's just these other ones were better. But yeah. Next up, we have Amazing. I've heard this song, and I'll save my review for after it. I did not make a video on this song, so yeah. again with the strings. I assume that is gonna continue on throughout the rest of the album. Amazing. That song was not amazing. Like it was great. but it was definitely, I would say so far, that song was the best song of this album so far. When it first came out a couple weeks ago, I was very impressed. It sounded a lot like Loving Is Easy, one of his more popular songs, from, I don't think he included it in an album, I think it was just a single, but yeah, this had a very similar vibe, and I wasn't a big fan of Loving Is Easy. I thought that song was overrated, but this song was very good. I like how in the chorus he tries to reach high notes, but it ends up raspy, and that is raw, which is nice in a song like this. So yeah, overall, very nice song, very cool. Next song, One in a Million. Funny how this has the explicit label, but Open the Window does not. All right, let's go. No strings.
There's nothing much I can do. I'm aware. There's no one quite like you. You're
I love the melody and beat on this. This is fire. There's the strings. I like how dramatic that sounds. Dang, one in a million. That song was one in a million. That was a really good song. I will say that is probably the best risk that Rex Orange County has taken so far in terms of his music, because a lot of his music is very, you know, indie, a lot of rock here and there, but it's usually just limited to that. This song, along with some of the other songs on this album, has, you know, tried different genres, especially with Open a Window or Worth It. But this one, like, has the best return to investment. Return on investment, I mean, I think. That sounded really good. Again, very 90s. Another theme of this album. Strings and 90s sounding. Next up we have If You Want It. Let's go.
Baby, wait.
a little repetitive. If you want it, if you want it, meh, it was a cool beat, I'll admit, but in terms of the overall song, not a sponsor, it was, I don't know, it was a bit too repetitive. I liked the effects in the vocals, it was something new, this was a risk of a song to do because it's a whole different genre, but yeah, I don't know, it felt too repetitive and the key was also a little too low for his vocal range. Not really, I mean, I guess he does sing in that range a lot, but it felt very, whoa, it felt very, he wasn't ranging his vocals that much, if that makes sense. But yeah, it was aight. But next up we have 7 AM. Let's go. The beat in this. I've been liking the beats in a lot of these songs. And, once again. I like how the strings meet, mix with the beat in this. Excuse me, I'm wasting all the time. A little repetitive, but it's nice. I like the background vocals in this, the harmonies. Whoa, that was nice. That was a nice ending. The dun 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 dun. 7 a.m. Not bad. Not the best song, but definitely not bad. I don't know what else to say. The beat was nice. The bridge was a little repetitive, but it wasn't like, it didn't make me wait as much as I think, yeah, If You Want It, the previous song. If You Want It was like repetitive to a point where it's like, come on now. But this one is, at least it worked. I like the string, how the strings and beat fused together. And yeah, it was pretty good. Not too bad, not too bad. That's my final verdict on this particular song. All right, next up we have The Shade. The Shade. Let's see what this is all about. Sounds very indie off the bat, just the way the instruments are mixed.
Anybody else?
please don't go. Pause. There you go. Nice. That was a very wholesome song. Sad but wholesome. Nice. Yeah, I really dig that chorus. The not with anybody else, anybody else. That was very wholesome sounding. And yeah, it was also not too production heavy, which is nice. It was a mellow track overall. A nice mellow track. Yeah. Okay, next song. Making Time. Strings. Sounds very indie. I like how this is being edited. Making Time. It's aight. I think this song is more of an interlude rather than a proper track. Because it was pretty short. Yeah, it seems to be the shortest song. The shortest track of this album. So you want 1:55 compared, there isn't a single other less than 2 minute song on this. So yeah, I think it's more of an interlude. And yeah, it was aight. But I do like how they're playing with the sampling and editing of the instruments, the orchestra at the end. That was cool. Everything sounded too filtery for my taste, too indie in that sense. But yeah, that's that. Next we have Shoot Me Down. So far this instrumental stands out the most out of all the songs we've heard so far, just by how different it sounds. It sounds like a ballad. It sounds like an old rock ballad. Without the rock. But it gives the same vibe.
Thank you.
voice is clear all of a sudden. It's getting staticky. I like this effect. Ooh, that bass line though. Shoot me down. Very cool. I think that was a really good ballad. Again, another mellow song similar to, I think it was 7 AM or The Shade, one of those. But again, unlike any other song that he's released so far. I like the risks that he's been taking on this album. They've been paying off so far, I think. Another really good song. Very nice, very cool. I like the melody of the chorus. Don't shoot me down. Don't lose me now. Something like that. Yeah, nice. Very cool. Last and hopefully not least, Who Cares? The title track of the album. Who Cares? I hope this is a good closer because I like good closers. It sounds like an end credits song of a movie.
What are you supposed to do?
That was cool. That's very funny. Good closer. In terms of closers, I've never heard a closer that like winded down the whole album. You know, that song sounded very like, you know, end of the day, I'm tired, I just wanna rest type of vibe. Which, you know, fits the whole theme of this album of like, you know, all these like, you know, feelings throughout, and then all of a sudden, look, I'm tired and I just wanna wind down a bit. Good closer. I love the layering of the vocals in the chorus, and as well as in the second verse where he said he wanted to scream and then a lot of screaming came out. What I also particularly like was that the instrumental was simple. It was just that piano, dun 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 dun, you know, and the vocals were also like clear, mastered the same throughout, whereas, you know, there are other songs where his vocals were like effect and then no effect and effect and then no effect. This one was like just simple. It was plain. This song was very plain, simple, and nice, which I really enjoyed. So yeah, Who Cares was a very decent song. So yeah, that was the album Who Cares. I definitely did. That was a good album. Compared to Pony, actually no, before I compare it to other albums, let's do a save or no save. In case you are new to this channel, and to be fair, I've only done only one other video where I did a save or no save. At the end of an album review, I usually go through the songs again. I don't listen to them, but I just like list them out and see which ones I would save and which ones I would not save, because that kind of determines which songs you like and don't like from the get-go. And again, usually when I do save a song when I first hear it, it's not representative of what I will like grow into liking, because there are a lot of songs that I start off not liking but grow to loving it, and other songs where I think I like it to begin with but then I just get annoyed with it pretty quickly. So this is just a first impressions. Okay, so let's say Keep It Up, easy. I mean, I already have it saved. It's an old song. Open a Window with Tyler, the Creator, the only song with a feature on this album. Save. It had a really good beat. Worth It. I forgot what this sounded like, but I remember liking it. Yes, I do. Because I remember thinking that these two songs are pretty good. Better than Keep It Up. Amazing, nice. One in a million was good. What does it sound like again? Oh yeah, this one. Save. I remember saying to the camera that this song was one in a million. If You Want It. Oh, this was the repetitive one. If You Want It. I don't think I do. Yeah, I don't want to save the song. For now, because I don't know, that song was a bit too... It felt like a filler track. 7 a.m. Save. Right? Oh, yeah. Yes, 7 a.m. save. Oh, the shade save. I remember liking the shade. Making Time, the interlude song. Nah, it was... It didn't really hook me. Shoot Me Down, a good ballad. Who Cares, nice, simple, good closer. And these are the songs that I saved. I think I could grow into liking Making Time. I don't know if I could grow to like If You Want It though. I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, overall it was a pretty good album. Compared to Pony, let's see. Okay, I have all the songs in Pony saved, but if I'm being honest, like songs like Every Way, Stressed Out, maybe even Laser Lights, Face to Face, they're all right. But then again, where is it? Who Cares has, I feel like it's the theme stuck throughout a bit too much. It was like strings in every single song and like piano, you know? Like even though it did take risks in terms of the genres that he tried, the strings everywhere, while not bad, it as an album, as a collective, it feels repetitive, even though it makes sense to like have all the songs in the album like sound at least somewhat similar, have a theme motif, you know. Yeah, I don't know, I would have liked a bit more diversity in terms of like the sounds and instruments. But you know, this album had a couple bangers like Amazing, One in a Million, Shoot Me Down. Shoot Me Down sounded, it gave me the vibe of Silk Sonic's Put on a Smile. If you haven't heard that song, that's a very good song. And Amazing reminded me of Loving Is Easy But Better. One in a Million was nice, very nice. Yeah, I don't know. Overall, a pretty good album. Perhaps his best album. See, the thing is, Apricot Princess, right? Well, I have mixed feelings about this album. There are a lot of songs on this album I never saved. It has like his best songs in this album, including Never Enough, Four Seasons, and Television So Far So Good. Easily his best songs. Even after hearing his newest album, these are still the best songs he's ever put out. And I was hoping that he could top them, but I guess not yet. Well, it's these songs and also Best Friend and New House, in my opinion, but those are non-album singles. But yeah, that was my first listen of Who Cares by Rex Orange County. I hope you enjoyed. If you want to listen to, or if you want to watch my other album reviews, check them out. I've done Ed Sheeran, Silk Sonic, Bleachers. I think that's it. But yeah, do subscribe. This channel is very experimental and I like to try out different content. So yeah, I hope you like this video and the vibe that I put up. Cool.